All right, Roadshow Kitchen is the place to be today. Chef Bob Burke is here. Pot au feu is the place. We got we have lobster on the menu. We're going to talk hard shell versus soft shell. Good morning.
Yes, good morning.
Nice to have you here. You've got your sailing bow tie on. As always, you're ready to go.
Yeah, I was out on the bay yesterday. Yeah. Maria Bajonia Hart and her husband Tony Dolly.
Nice.
Took us for a little cruise, and I think we should have just kept going on to Blanc Island.
I think you probably should.
If I'd known Michaela was down there. But what we're going to do now, I'm going to ask you to pick up these two lobsters.
Okay, so we'll pick these guys up. Yep.
So now, as you pick them up, just give a little squeeze to the body there.
Okay, I can already feel it.
That's the difference.
That's the
difference.
Are they two different kind of like, I mean, they look, if you just look at these, they look exactly the same.
Exactly.
They look exactly the same, but you can, the second you pick it up, this is the soft shell, correct?
Exactly.
Right.
And what happens is that most people don't realize lobsters will have up 15, 20, maybe 25 different shells in their lifetime.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. In the first year alone, they have about 10. And what happens is of course, the shell can't grow.
Mm-hmm.
So what the lobster does is the lobster shrivels up inside the shell, casts off the big shell, and then grows a new soft shell and basically lives in that. But there's lots of room in the soft shell for them to grow.
Right.
It's like when you buy a kid's shoes. You always buy a size too big.
A little bigger.
Because they're going to grow into it. Well, the lobster's the same way.
Is there more meat in one of these comparison? Or
A lot more meat.
A lot more meat. Okay.
And that's what we're going to look at today. We're
going
to have some fun with it. We're going to look at some big lobsters.
And man, the lobsters he has over here, they are how big?
These are five pounds each. Hard shell.
Bob said, wait till you see the meat that is going to come out of these giant lobsters over here on our right-hand side. So we are going to put this together. We're going to show you all about this, take apart these lobsters, show you what the meat looks like and everything else, and get right to it. There we go. So now we are in the Roadshow Kitchen. Bob Burke is here. We have lobster. You know, if you're hanging out today and you want to come over, come have some lobster over here at the on the Roadshow. What are we doing now? You've got a bunch of lobsters. These are big.
You're going to have a line in the park.
Today. You can have my share.
You've got some extra lobsters.
It's your treat today. All right, what do we need to do right now? Can you have some water steaming?
What do you
want to
do when you buy your lobsters, okay? And right now the market's really good. You're going to see lobsters even down to $5.99 a pound on some of the promotions.
Right.
And you don't have to know how to tell, but you saw before how if you squeeze it, the soft shell.
It's very easy.
That's not going to have as much meat in it as a hard shell. You just need to ask. Say, do you have a hard shell in there? I'd like to get the hard shell because it's going to be packed with meat. It's going to have much more meat than the soft shell.
Because the space is all filled up in the shell.
And what they're going to do is grow into it.
Mm-hmm.
And now what we're going to do is we're going to steam this lobster. And I'm just stirring in a little tiny drop of vanilla. Vanilla makes lobster taste more lobstery.
Okay, and we want that.
Of course we want that.
Told you I want it to taste more like steak, but that's okay.
And then what I like to do, every so often I've had lobsters where I think I can taste the rubber. Okay?
The rubber band.
The rubber band. So it's dangerous because this is called the crusher.
Mm-hmm.
The crusher.
The crusher.
And this is over here called the pincer.
Okay.
Okay?
Right.
And you do not want to get caught with the crusher or the pincer, but we're just going to put the lobsters right in the pot.
So what else did you, what else have did you put in here? You just put a little salt.
Would you put a little salt in?
I do need a little salt. We have a little all-purpose salt in
here. The best way to do this is actually in seawater. If you've got a little, seawater from the beach, that's the best because you're going to get lots of additional flavor. If not, salted water, just a touch of vanilla. Now, we're going to put the lid on, and you notice they're not submerged.
Right.
We're not boiling them. It's a shallow pit. Steaming them lets some of the lobster juices stay inside.
Okay. Are there any final words? Oh, okay, here we go. Sorry, guys.
And we're going to start our butter.
Mm-hmm.
And again, if you wanted to put just a touch of, I always add I use salted butter, and then I add a touch of salt to the butter because I love salt.
Okay. All right, good. So we've got the butter here. We're going to show you what everything looks like when it's all said and done. And these guys are 5-pound lobsters, and Bob's going to take them apart, show you how much meat you actually get when you buy a large lobster like this. So in the meantime, back to you.
Here we are back at the Roadshow Kitchen.
Bob's still trying to convince me to try the lobster.
Chili
day. Not going to happen. Chef Bob Burke's here. Pot of fruit someplace. This hard shell, soft shell lobster. Oh. That's what we are cooking. That's what we're learning about today.
This is what people don't like about lobster. This is the tamale.
Right, the tamale, that's green.
The liver.
Right.
And this is the roe. And some people claim these are delicacies.
All right.
They are not.
Who are those people?
Tell your children that, okay?
I want names.
I would not eat either of these.
All right.
But you know what they're really great for? In a few minutes after the show, we're going to mix all of the shells and the tamale and the egg into a pot, and we're going to make bisque.
Okay.
Oh,
so,
yes.
Yeah, part of what I want to show you today is that a lot of people just eat a lobster, and then they throw the shells, and they're done. Well, the first thing I did is I took the body of the lobster, okay?
Yep.
And we picked all of this meat.
Look at all that. You were showing us the amount of meat that came out of there.
There's a lot of stuff.
Phenomenal.
A lot of
now,
meat in there.
That's a 5-pound lobster. And the prices for the big lobsters are much lower.
Ah.
So this is $6.99 a pound for these huge lobsters, and you get so much more meat out of it. So inside is what you want to go for, okay? And in here, look at the size.
There really is a lot of stuff. You can see
wow,
it.
Yeah.
Look at
just
the size out. Of the meat
that.
That's in
it's
the
inside,
body of that lobster. I mean, that's huge.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something you want to do. And then even here, on the claws, when you break the claws, this would be a good one. When you break the claws here, and then you squeeze the lobster meat out.
Oh,
okay?
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of stuff in
you
there,
just
too.
Squeeze the claw like this, and out it comes. Mm. Oh, my God.
Yeah. If you want to pause
so
that DVR right about now,
so
once you do that. Now,
I can hear the pot rattling.
Now,
I think they're done.
What's the next move?
Take the lid off.
It's okay to touch the lid?
Use the tongs.
All right.
You know,
the lid is not going to be red hot. Okay. Now, where are these boys going? Right on this plate right here,
sir? Yeah, put those boys on the plate.
Oh, that is hot.
So you got those.
How many are those? These are about 1 1/4 pounders. And we're going to show you the difference between that soft and hard shell. And you notice I put the ramekins
in
there as well.
Right.
Because when we put the butter, right?
Oh, what do you want
we're
to
going
nice?
To want the butter to be in a steaming hot ramekin. There's nothing worse than eating lobster with cold butter.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
Now, this guy, there we go. The hard shell versus the soft shell. Now, you want them always steaming, steaming hot.
All right, my question is, even after they're cooked, can you tell which one is the hard shell and which one's the soft shell? Okay.
Yeah, give them a squeeze.
I didn't know.
Okay. And see?
You can still tell.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Watch. See the soft shell?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
See that?
And
the hard shell, I can't even crack.
You can't even crack.
You can go like this and tell. See that?
Yep.
How hard that is?
Who is it?
Yeah, that's right.
Knocked on.
Brendan and Will are at the door. I'm going to do that move that you did over here just a second
and
ago with
you
the
do
butter.
That. And then
that.
What we're
going to
do is we're
going to
break it open.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And we just want to see that the if they're a red row that they cook through, okay, or the tamale. Now, this is really cool. When you break open a lobster shell, okay, a lot of people cut them in half and really work it.
Yeah.
If you just break the middle
of the tail,
the middle fin out of the tail, okay, you can actually take the lobster and push it out and through, and the whole tail will come out in one piece.
So you don't have to do all that work.
You don't have to do all that work.
And there it is, slowly.
Go ahead, make a liar out of me. You know, the thing is I need like a... Do you have a wider...
Like I know what a wider is.
A blunt instrument.
Oh,
right, to pull it out.
All right, here, what we're going to do is just grab it with this.
So for anyone who doesn't know, how long should the lobsters actually cook for or steam for?
I like to cook a lobster for about 7 minutes for the first pound, and then about 4 to 5 minutes for each pound.
For each pound afterwards.
And the address of your establishment one more time, Bob.
The Potiphar is downtown Custom House Street. And I also wanted to mention something. This Thursday, we're doing Soup on a Mission.
Okay.
And it's a fundraiser for the Providence Rescue Mission.
All right.
And we've got loads of restaurants coming.
That's
Everybody's
going
to bring a pot of soup, and you can have lunch.
It's all going on.
Sounds
this
good
is
to
the
make.
Guy right here, Bob Burke. I can't wait to sample this.